Sir,
Transportation
wait, sir,
market.
wait, sir. Please wait, sir. We are making a note of it.
Somebody is asking a question. Transportation model. In that we are covering the first topic. Yeah, operations.
Do you want us to write that second table also, sir, which is below down the line?
Second table, you can right now not required. It is for my calculation.
Okay. Of all the subjects, we are feeling this subject only very difficult, sir.
Generally, even inside the classroom, I remember up to 120 students, up to 50 to 60 students used to fail in the subject when we cover the physical mode. Okay,
yeah.
It is because we are doing lot of small calculations. What do you call fourth standard, fifth standard calculations? These calculations only certain people can do it fast.
Not only that, sir, to understand that concepts also,
okay.
It is becoming bit difficult, sir.
Concepts,
Ramakrishnan, sir.
Concepts are very powerful in the sense today, almost all the companies they are using, started using these things. Transportation model, assignment model, PERT-CPM.
Sir, could you be able to see the problem?
Yes, problem is there now. Sir, if we observe the total here, either horizontal row or vertical, this one, the total is not maybe how to understand that
60, 90, 100, 175.
Demand and supply.
Oh, here 1, 3, 4, 3, 7, 11, 14, but it is 20 here. Here,
this
1, 2, 4, 8, 13, 2, 15, it is 20. 30.
Yeah. I'm not
here,
getting.
30.
Sir, this is
horizontal.
Will not total. This is, I told in the last class, from factory 1 to destination 1, if it's 1 unit, 1 rupee is the transportation cost. If you send from factory 1, origin 1, to another place, that is market 2, every 1 unit transportation cost is 2 rupees. The numbers inside, they are all transportation cost. This total will not
okay.
equal to 3.
Okay. Transportation cost.
Per unit transportation cost, O1 to D1, every 1 rupee you are sending, or every 1 unit you are sending, you will be spending 1 rupee every 1 unit from factory 1 to market 2, you will be spending 2 rupee per unit. Every factory 1 to market 3, every 1 unit you are spending, you are supposed to spend 1 rupee. Same product, if from factory 1 to market 4, you will be spending 4 rupees. So the numbers inside,
maybe the distance may be more.
Last class itself, we have discussed this part. And the factory 1 availability 30, factory 2 availability 50, factory 3 availability 75, factory 4 availability 20, demand at market 120, demand at market 240, 30, 10, 50 and 170, total 175. When demand, when we have a case, when the demand equal to supply, we call it as balanced transportation model. This one also, I gave the explanation in the last class. We call it as balanced transportation problems, balanced TP. We will solve the problem of getting initial allocation by using a method called Northwest Corner method. Northwest Corner method. So in the Northwest Corner, we have to take the table. I take the empty table with the demand and supply. Then I identify what is the northwest position of the table. So northwest position of the table is cell 11. The cell 11 is the northwest position. So the market requirement 20 units, demand is 30. So this factory one, to the entire market, the D1 can get something from factory 1, something from factory 2, something from factory 3, something from factory 4, but total it needs 20. So the current situation, northwest corner says, the entire demand for the market, D1, can be given from the 30. So I compare the number 20, I compare the number 30, the lowest is 20. That means this 20 can be given here, the 20 is cancelled. The availability, 30 units available, that is reduced now 10. That is the first allocation. I compare demand, I compare supply. Demand is 20, supply is 30. So I compare demand and supply. The entire demand 20 can be taken from the 30. So the first allocation is made to the cell. This is the cell 11. We are making allocation. That is factory 1 is supplying to market 1. Now the market 1, entire 20 is coming from factory 1. So there is no need to consider the remaining places. I just remove the remaining places, that is from factory 2, factory 3, factory 4, need not supply anything to market 1. That is the reason we are cancelling the column. So that is the first step. I compare what is the demand, I compare what is the supply. So demand is lesser, supply is more, I cancel the demand. Entire demand is fulfilled from the factory 1. So factory 1 initially it was having 30, now it is reduced to 10. Now the reduced table, what is the northwest position? The reduced table, what is the northwest position? Cell number?
C12.
12. 12 is the northwest position. D2. O1, D2 is the northwest position. 1-2, cell 1-2 is the northwest position. Market 2 requirement is 40, but factory 1 can give only 10 units. So I allocate 10 units here. So the 10 units the 10 units are fulfilled, out of 40 it is reduced to 30, that you are giving 10 units to the market 2. Now factory 1, initially it was having 30, 20 units given to market 1, 10 units given to market 2. So that means this factory cannot supply to D3, D4, D5, D6. So I am just cancelling these portions. So first step, I compare 20 and 30, I gave the entire 20, cancel the 30, reduce to 10, then I compare what is the northwest position. Cell 1-2 is the northwest position. Factory availability 10, market requirement 40, so 10 is given till the market needs 30 units. In the meantime, factory 1, this factory 1 finished, 30, 20 gone here, 10 gone here. Now in the reduced table, what is the northwest position? Cell number 2-2 is the northwest position. What is the availability? 50 units. What is the requirement?
50.
So 30 units can be given. Entire 30 units requirement can be met from the 50. So the 50 is reduced to 20.
20.
So 20. The market 2, entire market 2, 40 is required. 10 is coming from factory 1, 30 is coming from factory 2. So that means I don't need anything from factory 3 or factory 4. So I block, I remove. Now, again in the reduced table, what is the northwest position?
3 to 7.
Cell number 2, 3. Cell number
2-3,
that is market 3 requirement is 30,
requirement is 30, factory 2 can give 20,
yeah, 2, I put the 20 here, so what will happen, out of the 30, 20 is given, 10 more is needed.
10.
Entire 20.
In balance.
That means factory 2,
we can give 10.
So 20.
Then, again in the reduced table, northwest question. Cell number?
3-3.
Market requirement 10. So the 10 is given, market requirement 10. The 10 is given. This availability is reduced to
65.
So the factory requirements not required for market 3, we remove. Yeah. In the remaining table again, what is northwest? Cell number 3-4. So market requirement 10. So we remove. Reduced to
55,
and this 10 is 55. Again, in the reduced place, reduced table, cell number 35. Market requirement.
Yes, sir. 35.
So 50 is given.
Market requirement 50, available 55.
Yeah.
Five balance. Correct.
So, balance. Yeah. So that this market requirement is over. 50 is over. So we left out finally with one column where availability 5, where five. Availability 20,
25.
Requirement 20. So find out what is the total cost.
find out what is the Capricorn. What is the total cost?
Means we have to go to the previous table and here how many units are there and take the cost from the table and calculate.
Multiply. Yes, yes. 20 into 1, 10 into 2, 30 into 3, 20 into 2. One component, 10, 20 into 1, 20 rupees or 20,000, whatever be the 10 into 2, again another 20, 30 into 3,
680.
90, 680. So total cost, we found out 680. You check. $680 is the total cost of allocation. This is of estimation. The initial allocation, it is a kind of rough estimation. For rough estimation itself, there are three different procedures. For rough estimation, we are doing, this is one rough estimation. So, northwest corner.
How do we arrive at $680, sir?
I told you, you have to multiply 20 into 1, 10 into 2, 30 into 3, 20 into 2, 10 into 5,
20 into 2, into 9, next, 10 into 5.
Yeah, add all the numbers. You get 680. Somebody found out.
Clear, sir.
Then
50 into 6 is there, sir. 50 into 6 is there.
Yeah, yeah.
50 into 6 is there. That's okay, sir.
Yes. Into 6, 5 into 2, you the corresponding question you multiply.
Sir, kindly repeat, sir.
Sir, corresponding questions you multiply 20 units into 1 rupee, 10 units into 2 rupee, 30 units into 3, the respective questions you multiply. Per unit transportation cost, how many units you are spending? You are sending 20 units.
Sir, I think it's 740. It is 740, yes.
You check.
Sir, even I am getting 740, sir.
740, sir, not 680.
You check.
Sir, 740.
$740 is the initial transportation cost.
It is 740.
Yes. Then, so allocation, we have done three problems using northwest corner method. So, northwest, we solved three problems. The three problems, they have a major disadvantage. The steps, sometimes I remember they ask, mention various steps in northwest corner method. So the first one, what is the first step? So compare, identify northwest cell. Then compare demand supply. Whichever is lowest, allocate to the cell. Either cancel the row or column whichever is lower. Then the reduced table, again you are finding what is the northwest question. Then again compare supply and demand. Then whatever be the lowest supply, then cancel the row or demand or supply which are exhausted. So this is the one occasionally I have seen as a 5-mark question in few question papers. Don't ask what are all the things, because I see lot of question paper. I have occasionally this question paper, various steps in northwest corner method. Then what are the advantage of northwest corner method? It is quick to solve. That is the one advantage. What is the disadvantage of northwest corner method? The cost.
Means cost is not ending, not considered.
Sending the product to market with the lowest cost. So that is the major disadvantage of the question. But it is one of the useful procedure for getting an initial allocation, rough estimation. It is an idea to do the initial allocation, rough estimation. Then, to do the rough estimation, we have another method called the least cost method. Least cost method. So, least cost method is the second procedure. Most of the time this will provide slightly better answer. So again we consider the problem one which we have taken. What is the problem one we have taken? I remember we have taken a problem with the 3x4 initial problem, this problem 43. So let us take the problem again. We will solve this problem by least cost method. Let us take this problem. We will solve this problem by least cost method. First problem.
Sir, give 1 minute, sir. We will write, sir. 1 minute.
Yeah, I am also writing. So we take the problem. And get one rough table. We have three factories A, B and C, four markets D1, D2, D3, D4 and supplies. I take down the same structure. And supply. So the supply 11 units, 13 units, 19 units. Then I also put the requirements.
Demand 6, 10, 12, 15.
So we need to follow some procedures here. It is only a procedure, it is only a convention. Either you can keep two tables with you, or it is always better to have the information in one table. That is only a convention. You can have always two tables, but you cannot always do the calculations with the two tables. So it is better to keep the information in one table. So what we do,
okay,
in the table, what we do in the table, the cost I put it on the right corner. It is only a convention. The cost information I keep it in the right corner. So right corner always stands for transportation cost. It is only a convention. Convention for our convenience. We keep the information always, because when we do problems, we may do lot of calculations. It would be better to keep the data in one table always. So least cost method, the first step, identify the cell which is having lowest cost. Make the first allocation there. Which is the cell having lowest
cost? 1-4, sir. 1-4,
sir.
1-3. 1-3. Or 1-4.
Cell number 1-4. Cell number 1-4. Lowest cost is 13.
Okay.
So the factory can supply 11. The factory 13, can sir. Supply 11 and availability 15. So requirement 15, availability 11. I supply the 11 units here. The 11 units get exhausted. The 15 reduced to 4. So the supply, entire supply is given here. I remove
balance 3, 4, 4.
I can switch it.
Once we cancel. Sir, Radish sir.
Sir.
It is lot of noise from your side. Then, once you cancel the row or column, don't consider the cost in that row or column. In the available table, what is the lowest?
2-3, sir.
2, 3.
Cell number 2-3, lowest cost is 14. So we compare the lowest cost 14. Requirement is 12. Availability 13. So the 12 units. So allocation we are keeping at the center of the cell. That is the reason I told you have to keep some convention, because we are going to fill a lot of information. The 12, it is reduced to 1. Now, the column 3, it is cancelled, so you have to cancel only this portion. So column 3, already it is cancelled partially by previous allocation. Now column 3 is over. In the left out cell, again, what is the lowest?
Sir, not clear, sir.
There are two, sir. Actually,
two column is there.
2-1 and 3-2, sir.
You can make any allocation.
2-1 and
3. At two places we get lowest. You can make at any place. But it is, if you do a computer programming, as a programmer style, we consider whichever cell which comes first. So the row wise, whichever comes first,
2-1.
We make the allocation. It is only a convention. We cannot do random allocation. we can do anything, but as a computer programming like programming, we consider first row, whichever the row number first, it is 3 1, then 4 2. So instead of having 4 2 first number, we use, it is only a practice, it is only, there is no hard and fast rule. If you use this practice, everybody will be getting the same answer. That is the idea. So I use the first cell because I have two places, the first one 3 1, the second one 4 2. I use this first letter.
Sir, so
2 1 and 3 2.
Two cells with
two
the
one same. And 3 2
same.
2 1, yeah, yeah, 2 1 and 3 2. First number I consider lowest, so I go and allocate to the cell here. So requirement is 6, availability is 1. So I can make one allocation here. This one is cancelled. So this is reduced to 5. So that means the second row, it is getting over. So my second row getting over. So that means this cell is over, this cell is over. So now I comfortably left out with only one row. I cannot compare anything else.
Sir,
if you look at first row, second row, everything is blocked. Third row, only one row is left out. That is requirement.
You can give 5, 10, 5.
And 4, availability is 19. So 5, 10, 4, availability 19 is over. 4, this 10 is over, this 5 is getting over. So now, we just to do the calculation, what is the cost? 11 into 13. 130 and 143, first allocation, second allocation, 17 into 1, third allocation, 12 into 14,
168,
then 5 into 32,
160.
160. 10 into 70. 170. 4 into 41. 164. What is the total?
822.
8?
822. 822, sir.
822.
822. Eight?
Yes, sir. 822.
822.
Sir, one doubt, sir.
Yeah.
Sir,
yes.
if the same value is coming in two different cells, that here in this case that 17 is coming in two different cells, so we will consider the one,
okay,
in the first, the is it that?
Yeah, you can do, but there is no correct answer here. We are not getting the final answer. I told it is only rough allocation. If you choose another 17, you will get different answer. That is possible. You can get two different answers for this problem. Very much possible.
Sir, if we consider the C2, will it be okay with the answer?
Yes, that is also another answer for this problem. More than one solution.
Clear, sir.
Then, the bigger problem which we solve now. So this problem, I know that this will cover almost many things which we have done so far. Again, we cover this one using least cost method, because you have lot of tiebreaker, lot of things you have to think and do. Can you start? Can you complete the problem?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. We will complete and come back, sir.
I will solve parallelly. You can cross check. Once you, I will take 2 minutes break, then I will start the problem, so that you can cross check your answer. Already the problem is taken down by you.
Go back to previous page, sir, kindly. Wait, sir.
Solve the problem parallelly. I use the same table for filling or allocation. I use this pen for filling that. So printed information, that is cost, transportation cost, allocation will be done by the manual pen. So the first allocation, the lowest cost is 1, it appears in many places. So the first allocation, I make it to the cell. I make it to the cell, first one, so 20, I allocate the 20 here, I allocate the 20 here. I allocate 20 here, then this is cancel, this 30,
reduced to 10. Again, in the remaining table, the lowest cost, again it's 1, the same row. So I allocate to this 10. To this 1 and reduce this 30 to 20. So what happened in the process? Factory 1 over. So I remove this number, I remove this portion. So table 1, row 1 is removed completely. Again, in the table, what is the lowest cost? Again, 1.
Sir, again in the second row, sir, 4, 2, 1 is there, no, sir?
2, 4. 2, 4. This place and this place. This is 2, 4. This is 4, 2. So, lowest, the, I consider at the convention. Allocate to this
sir,
one.
Could you kindly tell that convention again, like how to consider the rows and columns, which is to be considered first?
One is coming in two places. 2 by 4, cell number 2, 4. Another occasion, it is coming at cell 4, 2. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So I consider the lowest in the first place.
$390, sir.
Once your doubt is over, you can mute your microphone, unable to speak. Mr. Biswas. Then, I consider the one is coming in two places, 2, 4 and 4, 2. I choose the first place lowest, so are the row which comes first, that is easiest one. The row which comes first I choose always. So the requirement is 10, I allocate the 10, it reduced to 40. The process, this 10 is over, so that means market 4 getting exhausted. Again, the lowest is 1. It comes here, 4, 2, requirement is 40, availability 20, I supply this 20 from this factory, so it is reduced to 20,
sir, I'm not
that
able
means,
to
that means this factory 3, factory 4 cannot give anything. Then, in the reduced table, what is the lowest cost? 2 is the lowest cost. 2 is coming in 3 places. 3, 2, 3, 6. Where will we allocate?
3, 2.
3, 2, 3. We allocate to 2, 3. We allocate to 2, 3. Availability 40, requirement 20,
So the 20 can be allocated to this cell. So in the process, marker 3 requirements are given and 20 is given. So it is reduced to 20. That means marker 3, you don't need anything. So it is removed. Again, 2 comes as the lowest. We are giving to the first one, 3-2, and this is 3-6. First one we allocate 20 and 75. So 20 is given out of 75. It is reduced to 55. This 20 is given. So this is reduced. So column 1 over, column 2 over, column 3 over, column 4 over, you are left out with a small 2x2 table. Again, what is the lowest? Again, lowest is 2. So requirement 25, availability 55. So 25 is given. So this is reduced to 30. So in the process, market 6 is over. Now if you look at, we are left out with only one column, 20 and 30. Requirement is 50. So 20 is given here, 30 is given here. You check what is the cost. 450. Cost check your answers. So somebody got the answer. Total cost is 450. So if you look at, in general, we have dealt with 2 procedures, northwest corner will always
and be least more cost
than least cost method. So least cost method in general will produce better number. From 450 to the final answer, it is easy. Whereas what is your starting answer you are getting? 800 something you got. Northwest corner, I remember you got some 820 or some answer.
822.
So roughly, otherwise you will be moving from double the amount to the best cost. Whereas it is always better to reduce the cost if you are slightly at a better stage.
List.
So 450 is a better stage to reduce the cost to final than 820. 820 also you can reduce, but you will take lot of steps. So some idea about least cost method.
Sir, excuse me.
Yeah.
Sir, in the examination, how the question will be asked, sir? Will it be asked to do in the LCM and northwest corner also, or only one?
Yes, sir. There's only one method. They will ask either get an initial solution by northwest corner or get an initial solution by least cost method. The third one, Vogel's approximation, we are going to discuss now. Get an initial solution by Vogel's approximation method. So they will specifically ask you. They will not ask all the methods. If it is northwest, least cost, definitely it is a 5-mark question, smaller thing. You know that the sums are slightly easier to solve. So not much difficulty. Whereas third one, which we are going to attempt, that is slightly a different one. Slightly a different one for which you need to do lot of calculation. That will be coming as a 10-mark question always. Is it clear?
Clear, sir.
Okay. The third one, you will be doing lot of calculations. This method, third method, we call it as Vogel's approximation method. Vogel approximation method. This will be often asked as a 10 mark question. Get an initial solution, rough solution by Wolff's approximation method. So if this is there, definitely it will always provide the best answer. This method will always produce the best answer, but you have to do slightly more calculation. That is the reason it will be always kept as a 10 mark question. So again, for comparison, I take the same problem one, first problem. Can you take the problem one? Same problem. This is the one we have taken. Same problem, I take it for continuation, because then only you can compare why one method is better. You want to have an answer. So that is the reason I use the same problem for comparison purpose.
Sir, 1 minute, sir, can we write down?
Take down.
Sir, the slide is not visible, sir.
It is visible.
It is visible, sir.
Now it is visible. On and off, it goes off from the screen. I don't know whether it is my problem.
Your internet problem or my internet problem, it can be anything. Because I am sending video also, my face is also taking some light. Also the second screen where the problem, naturally you cannot predict from which side you have real problem. These are all orders today, you want to bear that.
Sir, again we have to draw the same columns and rows for this problem also.
Same, but we will get a different answer. Calculation procedures are different. We have a
clear
different,
sir.
Calculation. Okay, the first step, say in the table, I put a first step calculation that I called penalty. So the penalty calculation, I will be doing a penalty calculation. So we will be just trying to have one extra space for doing the calculation, penalty calculation. So we will be doing penalty calculation instead of randomly choosing the row or column. This method is going to consider not only cost, what is the next lowest cost. So considering least cost, always consider the lowest cost for your allocation. Now we are going to consider not only the cost, what is the next least cost. So that next least cost also sometimes push your cost. That is the logic. So first step, what you have to do, identify the lowest and the next lowest in every row and every column. I consider the first row. What is the lowest cost and the next lowest? Lowest is 13.
Sir, kindly repeat, sir.
Identify lowest and the next lowest in the every row.
Sir, it is
13 and 11.
Sir, 11 is supply.
Okay.
13 and 15.
Sir,
1, 4 and 1, 2.
First row,
16
rupees and 13 rupees. So the difference is 13, 3. The idea
Sir, here, first row, least one is 13. Till this point, we understood.
Next least.
Next least means from the second row.
Banda erad nimisha ragade bartene
first row.
No, same row.
Same row next least means 16.
Yeah, correct. I take the next least.
Yeah.
The difference between 16 and 13.
3.
I have written the 3 here.
What the idea is the case, sir? Heading J.
Listen. The idea
sir,
is
better,
in case
sir, better heading.
J, you have denoted J. What is that? Heading.
It is not J. I said first calculation, penalty calculation. Okay. First I put everything under same box. One box I created, outer box I created. The idea of the three is, in case if you are not in a position to allocate to the lowest, the idea is considering the lowest cost. In case if I am not in a position to allocate to the 13, I will be spending 3 rupees extra for the next lowest. That is the idea.
Okay, sir. Next least cost idea.
That is the idea of the Vogel's approximation method.
Second row, 14 rupees. 14 rupees.
14 is the lowest. Next lowest is?
17.
17.
Again, 3.
In case if you are not in a position to allocate to this place, you will be spending 3 rupees extra. That is the meaning. What is the amount you are going to spend extra? We are doing the calculation, the extra cost calculation. How much we will be spending extra in case if you are not in a position to use the lowest? Again, the lowest is?
Yes.
17, sir, lowest.
17 and 18.
Next 18, 1.
Is 1. Again, for repeat the same thing for column, we will stop there. So, for the column, lowest is 17, next lowest is 21. So, 4 is the missing cost. 16 and 17, 1 is the extra spending. 14 and 18, 4 is the extra spending. 13 and 23, 10 is the extra spending. So we will stop here. We will continue in the next session.
Sir, this 4, 1, 4, 10, please explain again, sir. 4,
if I
1, 7, 4, 10.
I understood that question.
Till this point we understood 3, 3, 1. Till this point we understood. Next 4, 1,
for the same we have to take for column wise. Column wise we have to understand the next list.
Okay, fine.
We will discuss this in next class. Continue in the next class. Okay. We'll stop here. We'll continue.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Okay, column wise. Okay, thank you. Column wise.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
First, we have to take for row wise. Next, we have to take for column wise.
Yeah, thank you, Kavita ji. Malleswar Rao, baga speed ga undavu kada ya operations research lo. Kakinada anipichava.
Sir, actually, it would be better if sir can complete this this problem also. I think it will take 10 minutes, sir, but sir left the class.
It's a matter
because finance management will come. Kakinada, a teeralu potettunnayi samudranto anipichava Malleswar Rao.
Sir, we will discuss privately. You cannot be in.
Hello.
Okay.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon. Myself, Dr. Chandrasekhar. Waiting for you.
Yes, good afternoon.
Yes. Can you hear me?
Chandrasekhar, sir.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. Chandrasekhar, sir. Vanakkam, sir.
Yes, vanakkam. Eppadi irukkeenga?
Oru nimisham, rendu nimisham. Rest kudunga, sir. Subject-ku apparam subject. Subject-ku apparam subject. இதுக்குள்ள ஒரு நிமிஷம் ரெண்டு நிமிஷம் ரெஸ்ட் கொடுங்க சார்
ஓகே 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 ஓகே
only 5 minutes break is enough.
Okay.
Malleswar Rao, then 2 minutes adi the 5 minutes chestam.
At least we will get out of from this previous class and we can be ready for next class.
Yeah, very good, very good. Very good idea. That's why it said idea will change the life.
So if everybody ready, we can start it.
5 minutes over? 5 minutes over?
Enough for me, enough.
Just one it's or okay, two sir. Minutes there.
Okay.
Chandrasekhar sir, unga ishtam start pannalama, start pannunga.
I can start. Okay, problem.
Yeah, sir, you can start.
Okay. Remember what we discussed in previous law? Okay. So last class we discussed about
retained earnings.
Retained earnings. That means cost of capital, right?
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Cost of capital, different models.
Yes. So cost of capital, different models we discussed in the previous class in the last week onwards. Okay. So like cost of equity capital, debt capital, preference capital, and the retained earnings. CAPA method and total overall weighted average cost of capital.
Excuse me, sir, there is a sound problem.
What madam?
Sound problem.
No sound problem.
It is come from participant side. If you are going to
yeah, mute, that's right. But you are clearly audible, sir.
Yes. Okay. So this is the next concept. It's announced. Okay, next concept we are going to discuss about leverage. It is an important concept using in the organization before going to fix the capital structure. I already said in the last class about the capital structure. Capital structure means the total required capital, how we are going to raise proportionately or how we are going to give weightage in between the debt and equity finance. It is called the capital structure. When you are going to fix the capital structure, it is not easy one. The capital structure directly will affect the equity shareholders' return. So, the fixing proper combination is very much important. Before that, we have to analyze our organization very whether any leverage point is influencing or any factor is influencing to change the sales or earnings of the equity shareholders. Etc. That concept is called leverage. This concept we're using in the physics also, you already know that. I have given an example in slide itself, the image in the slide itself. If you want to get huge success, we have to use some lever to lift the weight from one place to, or to move the weight from one place to another place. So the huge success is return. If you want to get the return, we have to mix the debt and equity combination properly. So how can mix? things we are going to discuss in the following slides. It is an investment strategy using borrowed money, specifically the use of various finance instruments like financial instruments, debt and equity, preference shares. Sometimes if it is existing firm or existing organization, use the retained earnings also. Also, leverage can also refers to the amount of debt a firm uses to finance asset. One side borrowing money, another side creating assets, financing for assets. So which combination of fund is helpful for us, or which combination of fund will maximize the equity shareholders return? That things you can analyze with the help of leverage. It is a technique used by the business firm to quantify the risk and return relationship. If you are expecting more return, at the same time risk will be more. So what is the relationship between risk and return? That can be measured with the help of leverage concept. If the risk and return relationship is poor, that means if you're going to give negative effect in the organization or negative effect in the equity shareholders' income, we can bring capital structure, like minimizing debt portion and maximizing portion, or minimizing equity portion, maximizing the debt portion. That alternative can do, or bring alternative option of capital structure to minimize the risk. There are three types of leverages. One is called operating financial leverage. One, third one is combined leverage. Operating leverage will measure the operating profit. That means the percentage change in the operating profit. That means whether the sales is going to vary or the operating profit of the concern is going to vary with the effect of fixed cost. The cost can categorize into fixed cost, variable cost. You already know that. If you think of when we are going to compare the total cost, when you are going to talk about the total cost of the organization, a portion cost can categorize into fixed cost, a portion can categorize into variable cost. Fixed cost cannot change according to the sales or production of the organization. For example, if you're building or if your business running in a rental building, the rent will not change based on the number of unit sales or number of unit production. Rent is same, rent is constant. At the same time, same like that, if you are going to borrow some around 10 lakh rupees, whether you are going to produce or not, the depreciation for 10 lakh rupees will be same, and rate of interest for 10 lakh rupees will be same up to certain number of years. So those things are considered as fixed cost. Variable cost means when the cost will change according to the number of unit sales or number of unit production. For example, if we are going to talk about our family, the family expenditure also can categorize into fixed expenditure, variable expenditure. Fixed expenses is constant one. When we are giving the house rent, or when we are giving some subscription like newspaper subscription, etc., cable TV subscription, etc., these all is considered fixed one.
Maintenance charges also, sir, for yes, apartments.
Yes. And in case of we are purchasing groceries, that expenses will purchase payment for the groceries will vary from according to the market condition.
Particular goods. Yes. Excuse me. Sir, your voice is breaking, sir.
For everyone.
Yes. Sir, it's reverberating. Yes, sir. It's reverberating.
Okay. I'm not moving anywhere. Okay. So variable cost will change according to the degrees of sales or due to the change in the sales or changes in the production. So the operating leverage using to measure the relationship between operating profit to sales. It is defined as the firm's ability to use a fixed operating cost to magnify the effect of changes in the sales on its earnings. Normally, if it's a fixed cost, the operating leverage portion will be more. If there is no fixed cost, operating leverage, there will not be any operating leverage. That means by use of fixed operating cost in the business, it will bring change in the operating profit. So that can be measured, how much will be total fixed cost, how it will influence the operating profit of the concern can be identified in the name of operating leverage by using this formula. contribution by operating leverage is equal to contribution by EBIT. If we are unable to identify the contribution or whatever the thing, so this alternative formula can use degree of operating leverage is equal to percentage changes in EBIT and percentage change in sales. There will be two EBIT, there will be two sales. So difference in EBIT and difference in sales can bring to identify the operating leverage. And in case of financial leverage, it is deals with the financial expenses or fixed financial charges bearing by the organization. Like what is called fixed financial charges? If in case of except equity shareholder, if company borrowing money or company raising fund through debenture, there will be a constant rate of interest or payment of fixed rate of interest to be settled to the debenture holders. That is called fixed finance charges. In addition to that, if there is a preference share also issued by the company, so what is the fixed rate of preference shares dividend? That also constant to the company. The both are considered as fixed financial charges. After paying up to preference shareholders dividend, if there is any excess profit will goes to the equity shareholder. So the mix of debt and equity, if there is a more debt finance, if there is a more preference finance than the equity shares, how it is going to influence the equity shareholders earning per share? That can be measured with the help of financial leverage. It is equal with the, exactly we can use financial leverage when we are preparing the capital structure. And so both combined leverage, the both are how it is going to influence in the sales, operating leverage as well as the financial leverage, how it is going to influence in the equity shareholders' return. That can be measured by using combined leverage by multiplying the average leverage and financial leverage. I'm going to share Excel sheet. So it is a continuous one already with you. I already shared the link. Here we are going to measure the form. Already I have brought formulas and etc. Can you follow me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Can you see this one, Excel sheet?
Yes, sir. 1 minute, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir. We can see it.
Okay. So I already explained about the profitability statement in capital budgeting itself. When we are preparing capital budgeting, there either when we are going to analyze the capital budget project through the payback period method or average rate of return method, or internal discounting factor, or whatever may be the case, first we have to prepare the profitability statement to know the fund available to the or income available to the equity shareholders. The same statement with the same concept we are going to follow here is called a profitability statement. So this is a formula. A firm sells its only product at rupees 12 per unit. Its variable cost rupees 8 per unit. This variable cost 8 rupees will change according to the number of unit sales or number of unit production. Present sales are 10,000 units. Calculate the operating leverage in each of the following situation. They are asking to calculate operating leverage. You see, there are three situations is given by them. When fixed cost is rupees 10,000, or fixed cost is increased to 12,000, when fixed cost is increased to 15,000 rupees. So this is a formula. Operating leverage is equal to contribution by EBIT. That means how this fixed cost is going to influence in the operating profit of your concern. That only we are going to discuss here. If fixed cost is increasing, whether it is going to influence more or operating leverage will be more or less, can estimate with the help of using this formula. For that, we have to prepare profitability statement. Can you follow me?
Yes, sir.
This is a profitability statement. Okay. So at a time, we can calculate for all three options. This is a situation one or point A. We can mention like that. This is for point B and point C. So sales is the main factor. Sales. How many units selling by them? Totally 10,000 units. Selling price also constant. Sold per unit, right?
Yeah.
So sales, how many units? 10,000 units. Into 12 per unit. It will be 1,20,000, na?
Yes, sir.
So 1,20,000 will be sales in all situation. Okay. Sales less variable cost. So variable cost is by them. How much variable cost? Variable cost is
8 rupees, sir.
Yes, 8 rupees per unit. This also constant in all aspects. 8 rupees. Okay. So how many units? 10,000 units.
10,000 units.
80,000.
80,000 for all.
Okay. 80,000 for all situation. 80,000. 80,000. 80,000. Okay. The differences between sales and variable cost is called a contribution.
40,000, sir.
40,000, sir.
All A, B, C, all 40,000.
40,000.
Less fixed cost.
Yes. Less. Fixed cost. Now the fixed cost is changed.
Yes, sir.
There are three situations given by them. For first situation, fixed cost is 10,000 rupees. For second situation, fixed cost is 12,000.
Third situation. Third situation.
15,000.
15,000.
Yes. Okay. Now we can calculate. Differences between contribution and fixed cost is called operating profit or earning before interest and tax. It's called operating profit, also called an EBIT, earning before interest. That means before deduction of interest, before of taxation, we have identified that we have operating profit of 30,000 rupees. Yeah.
25,000.
25,000, right. So what are the information is required for us to calculate the operating leverage?
Contribution and EBIT.
We have calculated both, right?
Yes, sir.
Now we can calculate operating leverage equal to. How much is the contribution for this one?
40,000.
So we can apply the same formula, contribution by EBIT. Contribution, how much contribution?
40,000
divided by operating profit.
1.33, sir.
Okay. 40,000 divided by
28,000.
28. And here 40,000.
Right.
1.43 is called operating leverage. Now, how to interpret this one? If they are asking to interpret the operating leverage. Here, if where operating leverages will increase for every changes in the fixed cost here. Operating profit will increase for every change in the fixed cost. If fixed cost is increased, automatically operating profit also going to increase. At the same time, where fixed cost is increased, the risk of the business is also going to increase. Why you are saying like that, sir? If we are ready to bear the more, ready to bear more risk, automatically we can get more benefit from the business or from the market. So how the risk will going to increase if in case of fixed cost is going to increase? If business is growth oriented firm or growth oriented business, no problem, we can manage. Or unexpectedly, if income of the business is going to falling down, we have to bear the fixed cost, no other go. You see, whether the production is, whether we are producing or not, we have to pay the fixed charge of electricity bill or fixed charge of rent or fixed EM installment charges, etc., etc. Everything will be there.
Yeah. Salaries, everything.
Right?
Yeah.
Okay, so here for every one time change in the fixed cost, 1.33 time will change in the operating profit. Okay, so we have to keep it in our mind.
Here, please explain again, sir.
Could you kindly repeat it like here every
interpretation, sir? Interpretation
here every 1.33.
Every 1% change in the operating profit, sorry, 1% change in the fixed cost will influence in the business. Will influence in the operating profit at 1.33 time.
Like, for example,
me, sir.
Sir, a variable cost, no, sir. What could that cost be, sir? An example for the variable cost?
Variable cost, material price, lab price, right?
What price?
Material cost.
Okay, that would be constant. That will not vary, sir. We have taken it as constant.
Variable cost means it will be, right?
It will be on the production, number of product.
Yeah, production is going to increase. What will happen? Variable cost per unit will not change, but the total amount will going to change.
Okay, sir.
For example, per kg of material is 10 rupees means, 10 rupees is constant, but the total cost will vary.
Correct, sir. Got it, sir. Got it.
Okay, but fixed cost is not like that. Fixed cost, total
rent
cost is constant, but rate per fixed cost will vary. If you are going to produce number of units, it will be benefit to you. This is a marginal cost concept.
Okay, sir. Got it, sir.
Okay. So here, every possible change in the sale. Yes.
Sir, so how can we correlate, a firm's profitability and operation leverage?
So when the fixed cost is increasing, operating profit is reducing and the risk is increasing accordingly.
The risk will increase. At the same time, when 1% change in the sales, there will be 1.33 time will changes in the operating profit. So we have to keep it in our mind. If 1% going to change in the sales, automatically it will influence in the operating profit. At the same time, 1% going to reduce, it will bring change in the operating profit.
Means it's directly proportional, right?
Proportionate basis.
Pardon?
Okay, so, proportionate basis, it will bring change in the operating profit of the business loss.
Okay.
That exactly we can measure by using the degree of operating leverage. If you're going for, if you want to say in percentage, we can use the degree of operating leverage.
Okay, sir.
Any doubt?
It's okay, sir.
So, if this if there is a high degree of operating leverage, will bring highest large changes in the operating profit. Based on the past experience, they can bring proper combination. Okay, based on the past experience, This everything is based on the expected information. For example, even when business is going to start, when before going to mobilize the finance itself, they can test their operating leverage and financial leverage. Then they can go for preparation of proper capital structure or optimum capital structure. Okay. If a firm have more or large number of or high degree of operating leverage, that will bring large changes in the operating profit.
You see? Okay. So positivity.
Yes.
The more are there. The more is the operating leverage, the more is the possibility of the firm to, grow in financial means, right?
Yes.
Okay. So
changes in the operating profit.
Okay.
It may be the negative or it may be the positively. You see, the operating profit of the concern is reduced, Operating profit for fixed cost is increased from 10,000 to 15,000, right? Hello?
Yeah, profit got reduced. Yes, sir. Profit got reduced.
10,000 to 15,000 rupees. That effect brought into the, that effect shown in the operating profit. Operating profit is reduced from 30,000 to 25,000, right?
Yes, sir.
So this operating leverage, you can correlate this last point C1.6 with the operating profit. If operating leverage is more, there will be large changes in the operating profit. It may be the positively or negatively. Understand?
Sir.
Okay. I'll show you the next example for you. Okay. This is the next one. If there is no fixed cost, what will happen? We can test here. X Limited sales 10,000 units of rupees, 10,000 units at the rate of rupees 20 per unit. The cost of production is rupees 14 per unit. The firm has a fixed cost of rupees 10,000. Assume that the sales of X Limited increased by 50%. Calculate the operating leverage for current situation and also calculate degree of operating leverage. DOL means degree of operating leverage if there is no fixed cost. They are asking two situations. First situation, calculate operating leverage for current. And if 50% sales is increasing, and third one is if there is no fixed cost, how it is going to change? Here we have to use alternate formula, like where two situation sales is given, two situation variable cost and operating profit is given. You see? We cannot use the first formula, this one, contribution by EBIT, we cannot use here, because there are two situations is given by them, where we are going to address both the situation single point. There we can use the degree of operating leverage, we can mention to the percentage. The percentage increase in EBIT divided by percentage increase in sales. How to calculate percentages increase in EBIT? Change in profit, that means current situation to future, and same like present profit. The same concept we can use for calculating the percentage increase in sales also. Here we can calculate or bring same profitability statement.
Let us write down the problem, sir. Problem two.
Give 1 minute time, sir. Please, 1 minute time, please.
Okay. You want to copy problem one?
No, sir. This one only.
This one. Okay.
We'll refer the sheet, sir.
Okay.
Sir, you will be sharing this Excel sheet now later.
It is already shared, sir. You want link once again? If you
sir,
are going
just
to,
1 minute, sir, please.
Okay, no problem. The link is already available. You can get from your friends. Otherwise, at the end of session, I will share once again.
No, sir, let me. If we want to follow now also, just 1 minute writing the problem. Very good, sir.
Over.
1 minute, sir. Over, sir.
If also, I forgot to tell one thing. You see, operating leverage of point C is more than all other two method. So how we can manage this one, or how we can utilize this one, how we can escape from kind of risk means, when we are trying to increase the sales of automatically, the operating leverage will reduce. Because this operating leverage given impact because of fixed cost. You see, after the fixed cost, there is no change in the contribution, right? The contribution for all three situations is same. 40,000, 40,000, 40,000. Right? If there is no changes in the fixed cost, operating also may be same. 30,000, 30,000, 30,000. The operating profit is reduced because of fixed cost. Fixed cost will not change time to time. Here the situation is given by them. You can take it as there are three types of form. Fixed cost will not change. If you want to get benefit from the fixed cost, we have to increase the sales. Right? For example, if producing 100 unit, sorry, yeah, 100 unit, the cost, total fixed cost for 100 unit is 1,000 rupees. How much the fixed cost for per unit, if you're going to calculate? The total fixed cost is 1,000. We have produced 100 unit. What will be the rate per unit?
Yes, sir. Understand, sir.
Yes, sir.
If sales, we are trying to improve the sales, then fixed cost is remaining same. Then for that, profitability will be increased.
Increasing. So higher the operating leverage is giving indicator to us what we have to do. We have to manage this one, how to increase the sales by using some different techniques like promotional activities, etc. Okay, this is the second one. X Limited sales 10,000 units at the rate of rupees 20 per unit. The cost of production is 14 per unit. The firm has a fixed cost is 10,000. Assume that the sales of X Limited increased by 50%. You see, they are trying to increase the sales by 50%. Calculate the operating leverage for the current situation, and also calculate if there is no fixed cost. The first you will calculate for current situation. This one is the current, and this one is future. Both we can calculate at a time simultaneously.
1.2, sir, and 1.125.
You have calculated.
First one, I think it's 1.2, sir.
Okay.
Let sir calculate, boss.
How much the sales? 10,000 unit, na? Risk speed, I think.
Yes, sir.
10,000 unit into
20.
20 rupees, na?
20.
Yes. So it will be?
2 lakh, na?
2 lakhs.
2 lakh, okay. And if sales is increasing by 50%,
15,000 units.
50% increase in sales. Okay. What will happen?
15,000
units. 15,000 units,
no? Into 20. 3 lakhs. So
15,000 units into 20. So it will be?
3 lakhs.
3 lakhs. Okay. Then again, less variable cost.
14 rupees per unit.
14 rupees, no? Yes, 14 rupees per unit.
14 into 10,000, 1.4 lakhs, 1,40,000.
How many units? 10,000 units into 14 rupees, it will be?
1,40,000.
1,40,000.
Here? 15,000 units?
15,000 into 14. 210, na?
2,10,000.
Okay. Now this is called a
contribution.
Contribution will be 60,000 and this one 90,000.
90,000.
Right. So contribution yes, is
10,000 fixed.
Fixed cost change. This constant 10,000 rupees. 10,000 rupees. So here operating profit
50,000, sir.
Are also called EBIT, earning before interest and tax, 50,000 rupees. Yeah,
80,000 rupees.
Yes. Now we can use this formula.
Percentage of increase in EBIT.
Yes, EBIT. First, you can calculate EBIT. Changes in profit divided by present profit. EBIT or percentage changes in
60%, sir.
60%.
60%.
You can if you are applying this formula, it will give the change in profit. How much change in profit? 10,000.
Sir. 50,000 is the first profit. Second situation profit 80,000.
Yes, a change in profit divided by
percent, initial profit.
No, change in
yeah, profit. 30,000 by
yeah, 30,000 divided by
50,000. Yeah,
60%.
What, sir?
60%, sir.
Yes, yes, it will be 60%. It will be 60%. Okay. The same like that. Percentage change in gains. So here, the difference between the sales, 1 lakh, na?
Yeah, that is 50% increase in the sales.
Yes.
Sir, where we get the 30,000, sir?
Okay. You see the formula. If you want to calculate percentage increase in EBIT, change in profit. That means from current situation to future. Differences between 50,000 to 80,000 is called 30,000, right?
Okay, sir. Okay, okay. Thank you.
Divided by present profit. How much is the present profit? Our current or present? Is it right here? Okay. So the formula is
100%.
Sorry.
Yes, 100%.
Okay. So now the degree of operating leverage.
What 100%?
Sir.
Yes, yes, sir.
What 100%? Percentage of increase in sales 50%.
Hey, tell me, sir.
No, no. Someone is saying 100%. Percentage of increase in sales 50%.
Okay, okay, okay. Fine.
Not 100%.
Yes.
Then degree of leverage. 60% by 50%, 1.2.
0.6, 0.5, right?
Yes, sir.
It will be?
One point two times.
1.2.
Yes. What 1.2 times. That means for every percentage of increase in sales, we'll bring changes in 1.2 times in operating profit. Right? Do you have any doubt in this one?
So just explain one more time.
For every percentage, every single 1% changes in the sales will bring 1.2 times or 1.2% change in the operating profit. If sales is going to decrease 1%, same operating profit also going to decrease 1.2%.
So sales increasing, and more than that sales, operating profit is increasing.
Yes. It will increase, or sales is going to decrease, also it will influence in the operating profit. Positively, yeah, as well as negative. Right?
Yes, sir.
The same concept if you are going to use here, if there is no fixed cost, you can assume that. If there is no fixed cost, you can use this concept here for both. What will happen, you see, if there is no fixed cost, EBIT will be the same. Right?
How, sir?
Operating profit will be 60,000 as well as 90,000. This contribution,
yeah, itself, yes,
is itself called EBIT.
Yeah, no fixed cost means contribution is equal to EBIT 50,000 and 90,000.
60,000, 90,000, yes, sir.
Yes.
If you are going to have the same procedure, DOL will be one time. That means no difference. If 1% sales is increased, operating profit also going to increase 1% or one time. Understand? If you are going to use the, yeah, same data for last point, you can assume there is no fixed cost. Here you can,
sir.
Yes.
Sir, in the first row where the 15,000 from where it came.
15,000.
Yes, 15,000 into 20 equal to 3 lakhs.
Yes, yes. You are asking
the second column.
Yes,
yes, yes, yes.
That one 50% sales is increased. Assume, you see the second line in the problem itself, assume that the sales of X Limited increased by 50%, right?
50%, yes.
Yeah, 50%. 50% on 10 unit. Because X Limited sells 10,000 units. Huh?
Hello.
Suppose in future, if sales is going to increase 50%,
10,000, yes,
plus 50%, it will become 15,000, right? Okay.
Okay, sir.
Any doubt?
Sir, one doubt. Sir, in that question, yeah, only we are like this thing, they're telling the sale is increased by 50% now, sir.
Yes, yes.
So, and we are again calculating the percentage of change in sale for why, sir? Why is that?
Yeah, because we have to bring now. They have given details for 10,000 units. This is a situation. They are asking to calculate. Assume you can assume sales is increased by 50%. If sales is increased by 50%, how it is going to bring changes in the operating profit?
Sir, your voice is very low, sir. I can't hear you properly. Sorry.
Oh. Okay, now I'm holding mic.
Yes, sir. So even I'm still not get clarified on the 15,000, sir. Can you please repeat again? Because your voice were very few people.
Okay. This is the present situation. X Limited sells 10,000 units. Normally at present, they are selling 10,000 units. That's all. Right? If suppose in future, if they are planning to increase sales 50%, how many units they can sell in future? The 10,000 units is already there selling in the market. Among the 10,000, 50% of sales is going to increase by them. So instead of 10, in future, 15,000 units they are going to sell in the market.
Okay, got it, sir.
Hello.
Thank you.
Up to this full stop, the concept is over. Fixed cost will not change whether sales is going to increase 200%, 300%, etc. Fixed cost is same. So we have taken the variable cost 14 rupees as well as the fixed cost 10,000 rupees. You see, the variable cost, total cost is increased. Variable cost, sales less variable cost, 14 rupees per unit. You see, for 10,000 unit, 1,40,000. For 15,000 units, 2 lakh, it will become 2,10,000 rupees. So variable cost is changed. But you see, fixed cost, there is no change in the fixed cost. Fixed cost is same. 10,000 unit for 10,000 unit and 10,000 rupees for 15,000 units. This is a concept. Fixed cost remains constant, it will not change.
Yeah, yeah. It's clear now, sir. Yeah.
Okay. Understood. If you are going to apply the same thing for this option B, you can identify that the DOL will be one time. There will not be any changes. That means if 1% change in the sales, the same 1% will give impact on operating. You can identify that one. Next, we can move to the financial leverage. Okay, I already said, by use of debt and equity combination, the operating leverage will going to vary. If your firm have more debt to finance, like debentures or more fixed financial charges finance. A fixed financial charges means interest as well as preference share dividend. The both are financial charges to the fixed financial charges to the firm. When they are going for proper optimum capital structure or fixing the proper capital structure, they have to check operate financial leverage because more financial leverage will bring more risk to the business. So to minimize the financial leverage, what they can do, they can go for combined or re-alter the capital structure, like minimizing the equity finance, maximizing the debt, or maximizing the debt finance, minimizing the equity finance, or any combination they can fix. Here, according to this problem, Buddha Limited has a choice of the following three financial plan. This three financial plan is called what? Capital structure. Equity share capital for first plan. They have first plan, equity capital. The last one, EBIT, separate one. Don't get confused with this one. Okay. These two, total they need 10 lakh rupees. Out of the 10 lakh rupees, on what proportion they are going to fix on equity as well as on debt? You see 6 plus 4, 10 lakhs. So that means they are focusing 60% on equity capital and 40% on debentures, debt to finance. Second plan, 50%, 50% on both. Third plan, they are giving more weightage on the debt to finance and minimizing the weightage on the equity finance, right? That's so 2 lakh and 8 lakh. If in this case, EBIT for first plan 2 lakh 50, second plan also 2 lakh 50, third plan also 2 lakh 50. EBIT means earnings before interest and tax. It will be constant.
That is given in the data?
Yeah, given in the data. Because EBIT, they have not given any sales or any additional cost, or variable cost, fixed cost, they have not given anything, right? Directly they have given EBIT itself. So now we no need to go for profitability statement. That means up to EBIT we have data. Okay. So you are required to ascertain the financial leverage in each case and interpret it. You're asking to calculate financial leverage. To calculate the financial leverage, this is the formula. EBIT by EBT. That means earning before interest and tax divided by earning before tax. Earning before tax means after payment of interest charges. Okay, to calculate that one, we have to go for profitability statement. Okay, EBIT is given by them. EBIT, earning before interest and tax. There are the three financial plan.
Plan 1, plan 2, plan 3. Yes.
We can make plan 1. Open. So, this one we can copy and paste. Plan 1, 2. 2,50,000 each. Okay. Now, less debenture interest or interest on debentures. How much the interest for debentures?
Sir, data in data, they have not mentioned the interest portion, sir.
10%, sir.
10% debentures.
10% debentures.
Okay. That means 40,000.
10% of 4 lakh rupees.
40,000.
Yeah, 40,000. And 10% on 5 lakh, na?
5 lakh. 50,000.
50,000.
Then 80,000. Plan 2, 50,000. Plan 3, 80,000.
80,000. Now?
Right, sir.
Meaning before tax.
The interest on the EBT.
Yeah. Earnings
2 lakh 10,000. 2 lakh and 1 lakh 70. 2 lakh and 1 lakh 70.
70.
1 lakh 70,000, right?
Yes, sir.
Now we can apply this formula, financial leverage.
1.19.
Yes. Financial leverage is equal to BIT.
2,50,000 divided by 2,10,000. 2,50,000 divided by 2 lakh. 2,50,000 divided by 1,70,000. Tell me.
1.19.
1.19.
1.45. 1.47. Then for the three plans, we got the financial leverage ratios.
Yes.
Is it percentage?
Time.
Percentage.
No, no. Time. How to understand that ratios? Interpret.
Yeah, I'll tell you, sir. Okay. Percentage. You see, this will give the relationship between debt and equity finance combination. Okay. You see, if you are giving more weightage on the debt to finance, your financial leverage will be more. That means it will do more risk also. Okay. If every change in 1% of sales will bring changes in the before tax up to 1.47 times.
Sir, kindly explain
For every 1% change in sales, will bring 1.47% of changes in earnings before tax. EBIT, na, previously we compared operating profit, now we are comparing with the EBT, earnings before tax. Right?
Sir, that interpretation is enough.
Yeah, that's enough. If you are giving more, if you are going for more combination or giving more weightage on the debt to finance, your financial leverage will be more. You see, according to the three plan, the debt and equity relationship 60-60.
Sir, if I have to, as a financial manager, if I have to give the recommendation, I have to recommend plan number 1 because the financial leverage ratio is less.
Chandrasekhar, we can sir? Give based on the return, sir. Return, earning capacity of the business.
No, sir. After calculating the financial leverage ratios,
yes.
Plan 1, 1.19. Plan 2, yes, 1.25. Plan 3, yes, 1.47. After yes. that, which plan I have to recommend to the board? Is it that's plan 1?
Yes, sir. That's why I'm saying we cannot recommend based on this one operating financial leverage like plan 1, plan 2, plan 3.
Okay.
If you are having more combination or giving more weightage on the debt to finance, your operating leverage will be more. So accordingly, you have to increase your rate of return. Understand? If your
we rate are unable to understand, more, sir, that portion.
Yes, sir. If your rate of return is more, definitely you can focus on plan 3. If there is more or higher level of financial leverage, there will be a higher risk. If you can, at the same time, we can get the highest rate of return. If your business have highest rate of return, you can go for plan 3. Otherwise, we should not go for plan 3. We have to choose either plan 1 or plan 2.
Sir, it means whenever the financial leverage is on the lower side, more healthy is the business, right?
More healthy is the business, but yes, at the same time, yes, tell me, sir. Business will not have fund for their expansion or growth.
Oh, okay, sir. Okay.
What is the reason behind that means? The interest, what they are giving, you know, you see for EBT, earning before tax, for plan 1 is 2,10,000, plan 2 is 2 lakh, and plan 3 is 1,70,000.
Yes.
Even because of, we have given more interest to the debenture holder. Okay. When, the, as per the international level, the optimum capital structure means, when our business have more weightage on the debt to finance and less weightage on the equity finance, it is called the optimum capital structure. Here, the plan 3 is optimum capital structure. If you have more earning capacity, we can go for choosing plan 3. But you have to keep it in our mind. For every 1% changes in the sales, it will give impact on 1.447 time in earning before tax.
Okay. The risk is on the higher side. Yeah.
Yes.
Yes.
For earning capacity is more, we can choose 3.
Okay, sir.
Okay. So based on this only, they will go for which method is, they will analyze the business earning capacity also. Based on this information alone, based on financial leverage alone, we cannot give recommendation to the people, recommendation to the businessman. Plan 1 is better, 2 is better, plan 3 is better. We cannot give. Some other factor also we have to measure. We don't have data regarding to the other factors like what is the earning capacity. Right?
Okay.
Tell me,
excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Sir, so you mean to say that it depends, the decision depends on the management, right? If they are ready to take the risk as the return is more, they can go for it. So if they doesn't want to take a chance,
for plan C. Yes.
Okay. If they doesn't want to take a chance, they go and go for plan 1.
Yes. This leverage will give the relationship between two variables. That's all.
Okay. So the decision depends on the management.
Yes, management. They'll consider other factors also.
So as a financial manager, we can give these options as possibilities and the risk also.
Yes, yes. But these are the main criteria they will take to prepare the capital structure.
Okay.
So the operating financial leverage they will take because they know that financial, as a finance manager, they know that what is the status of their business in the environment, right?
So that's what you mean to say, as a financial manager, we can just give the option of this and give, we can suggest. If we are ready to take the risk, we can go for plan 3.
Yes, yes.
Okay.
Based on this combination, they'll go for...
Understood, sir. Okay. So you mean to say some other data also is required. Not only on the based on the financial leverage, I cannot give the recommendation. Some other data also required. And then we have to give the interpretation and recommendation.
Yes, sir.
Okay, sir.
Okay. So it is giving
class is over, sir, for today.
Yes, sir.
I think class is over for today.
Yeah, time is up. I have given 2 more problem also. Those we can discuss on tomorrow.
Next class, sir. Okay.
Yeah. Like
thank you, sir. Problem.
Yeah, tell me, sir.
Hey, WhatsApp pochindi. We received WhatsApp, sir. I think.
This sheet, Google sheet, can you please share now in this chat box?
Yes, just a minute.
I think we received the WhatsApp also.
Okay, sir.
Sir, it's just in your system only. We couldn't get that link.
I have posted, na? Maybe network problem.
Yeah, got it, sir.
Got it. Okay.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay. Thank you. So the remaining two problems we'll discuss on tomorrow, and after that we'll go for working capital management. Okay, then theoretical aspect you can see like capital structure, dividends, and dividend policy, etc. Those things, if you have time, we'll discuss. Otherwise, tomorrow we'll go for working capital management. Because there
could
will
you
be a
please, sir, could you please share the slide link also? Because yeah, we got the Google link, but I missed that slide link.
Okay, now itself I'll share. Got it?
Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Sir, the recording of this class, sir, will it be uploaded in this in YouTube, sir?
Yes, sir.
Because from last week, even last week also, they have not uploaded, sir.
Yeah, I have seen. I'll ask them to upload. Okay. It will be available. Okay, you'll get
it. Will come in YouTube now. Okay, yeah, just in case if you want to just refer in case.
Sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Be helpful.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you for your time. Thank you so much for your time. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much for your time. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Friends, can anybody tell me that have you received any postal additional book which we had got in the WhatsApp group posted, like a consumer relation book, something they had posted that we will get through postal address, the additional book. Have anybody received it?
No, I have not received.
No.
Okay. Because they had mentioned in the WhatsApp group saying that from September end to October they have posted.
No, ma'am. We didn't.
Yeah, they have declared it, but nobody received it. Nobody received it yet. And we have asked for that also. They said they will check again.
Okay, thank you.